Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Truro Cathedral for this week's Friday lunchtime organ recital. It's a special privilege today to be welcome.
Bach's St. Matthew Passion, instigating the revival of Bach's music that has continued to this day, and the influence of Bach is very evident in the St. Paul Overture. This is a transcription of an orchestral piece, but it suits the organ remarkably well, to the point that my friend Peb commented, "Isn't it lovely when they arrange organ pieces for orchestra?" If you are a fan of Mendelssohn's organ music, you may notice that the form and structure of the piece is remarkably similar to the third organ sonata in A major. The next piece, Howells' first psalm prelude, has an entirely different affect. The work was inspired by a verse of Psalm 34. "The poor one cried out, and the Lord heard them and saved them from all their distress." It's an incredibly expressive piece with moments of grief, shock, anger, and comfort. This will be followed by Schumann's Canon in A-flat major, which was actually composed for the pedal piano. This instrument was very popular at the time. Since the piece was not written for the organ, it is great fun to treat it as a transcription and to orchestrate it. The first and final sections of the piece are quite lyrical. You can imagine a duet of singers with piano accompaniment, and the middle section is a bit more stormy. The last three works on the program are from the French symphonic repertoire. Duruflé wrote his Prelude and Fugue after his friend and fellow organist Jean Alain was killed in battle. The Prelude is characterized by a sea of intricate arabesque figuration with chant-like melodies floating above it. The Fugue subject is based off the same figuration, but it's slower and more plaintive. A second, more joyful subject played on the sparkly plein jeu emerges from it, and Duruflé combines the two subjects in a way that results in very exciting cross rhythms. Next, his Sicilienne from the Suite for Organ has one of the most beautiful melodies in the organ literature. It's absolutely dreamy. Finally, I will conclude with the finale from Charles-Marie Widor's Symphony No. 8. Thank you.